Sounds cool, push on her soul.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
I'm a new boy.
New girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka. Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Ah! Man! Ah! I-stop mo ako eh!
Uy! Ano ba? Uy! Huwag ka ang feeling!
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
I'm a new boy.
New girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka. Titig pa.
Sus.
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Ah! Man! Ah! I-stop mo ako eh!
Uy! Ano ba? Uy! Huwag ka ang feeling!
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
I'm a new boy.
New girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka. Titig pa.
Sus.
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Ah! Man! Ah! I-stop mo ako eh!
Uy! Ano ba? Uy! Huwag ka ang feeling!
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
I'm a new boy.
New girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka. Titig pa.
Sus.
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Ah! Man! Ah! I-stop mo ako eh!
Uy! Ano ba? Uy! Huwag ka ang feeling!
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
I'm a new boy.
New girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka. Titig pa.
Sus.
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Ah! Man! Ah! I-stop mo ako eh!
Uy! Ano ba? Uy! Huwag ka ang feeling!
Ah!
mas pa ako siya in person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
And new girl.
Ano? Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Huh? What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ka ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice! Mas guwapo siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
And new girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Huh? What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ka ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice! Mas guwapo siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
And new girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Huh? What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ka ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice! Mas guwapo siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
And new girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Huh? What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ka ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice! Mas guwapo siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
And new girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Huh? What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ka ang feeling!
Na-na-na!
Mas ko pa siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
New girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice, mas ko pa siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
New girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ang feeling!
Zoe!
Si Ice, mas ko pa siya ng person.
We're in college now. New world, new experiences, new people.
And a new boy.
New girl.
Magagandahan ka.
Titig pa.
Sus!
Na-hijack mo yung rehearsal namin.
Ha?
What if mag-merge yung mga banda natin? Mas magkakaroon tayo ng chance na makapasok sa music.
You think it's possible for you to like me?
Huwag ang feeling!
guys right back. All right, I'm back. Magandang tanghali po sa inyong lahat. As I said, thank you so much for joining us. It's really an honor to be here. And good afternoon, classmates. Lalo na sa mga nakatutok sa atin na yun sa ABS-CBN social media platforms and sa Black Sheep. Nanunod po sa amin na yun. Hello po sa inyong lahat. Salamat po sa pagtutok po sa amin. And sa lahat ng mga netizens po natin dyan, don't forget to use the official hashtag #ClashCon para magkita-kita tayo lahat dyan and create a conversation and make it aware na padating na ang inaabangan ng lahat. Bagong programa with ABS-CBN, ang #ClashCon. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the grand MediaCon of the one and only ClashCon. So once again, everybody, I am Jello Buencomino. It's nice to see everyone here. And sa mga netizens po natin, kamusta po kayo dyan? Don't forget to share the live stream, like and comment. And kung naka-live man tayo sa YouTube, don't forget to subscribe na rin. But yeah, hello everyone. I'm Jello Buencomino, your host for this lovely afternoon. Friday po natin na yun. So let's have some fun. So are you guys ready to meet the new kids? Thursday pa lang na yun. Excited all guys, kaya Friday na. Thank you for that. But yeah, are you guys ready to meet the new kids? I can't hear you guys. If you make it louder, sasend ko kayo ng GCash. Are you ready to meet the new kids? All right, there we go. So, welcome to the #ClashCon, the Teen Clash MediaCon, and finally, the wait is finally over na po. Nandito po tayong lahat and we're all so excited. Grabe. For the most anticipated series of Black Sheep this 2023. All right. So here we go. We're going to introduce the actors and the actresses na talagang pinaghirapan nila ang mga roles na to. From the creatives to the directors to the screenwriters, talagang tinodo nila for this project. So I'm so excited for this, genuinely. So let's introduce them. So first to walk on our blue carpet are the creatives of Teen Clash. We have the one and only, Polly and Simon. There we have Polly and Simon. Hello.
Hi, Polly and Simon.
All right, now let's call on the cast of Teen Clash, starting with Luke Alford. Luke Ford, he is giving John Mayer vibes, inspired ang outfit niya. Luke will be playing Lloyd, Isis' best friend and the colleague at No Name Bar. There we go, we have Luke. Next up, we have Fana. Fana's outfit is inspired by Avril Lavigne. Fana plays Sab, Zoe's cool friend who happens to be Josh's childhood friend and rival. Nako,
in winning Mandy's hearts.
Thank you so much, Fana. Next up, we have Ralph and Gail. Ralph and Gail's outfit are inspired by Shawn Mendes in Pink. Ralph's role is Ken, an anime geek and a bright student who competes with Ayumi for the top spot in their branch. Next up, mga kapamilya, we have Kobe and Andy! Kobe and Andy's outfit is inspired by Elvis Presley and Ariana Grande. Kobe plays the role as Josh, an alpha wannabe who aspired to be just like Xander, and competes with Zab on Getting Mandy. Andy plays Mandy, a campus darling admired and pursued by childhood friends Josh and Zab, who end up competing with each other. She's an online stan who becomes Zoni and Isis' number one fan. Next up, we have Zach and Bianca. Zach and Bianca's outfit are inspired by Bruno Mars and Jennie from Blackpink. Zach as Xander, he plays an alpha male, a former athlete with his certified playboy who can't move on from his on and off relationship with Yanni. Bianca plays Yanni, who is Zoe's smart and pretty friend, a bright, talented student who happens to be somehow stupid when it comes to love, and her on and off relationship with Xander. Yun, no? Alright, next up, we have the one and only. We have Direk Gino Santos! Direk Gino Santos is inspired by Kurt Cobain with his outfit. He is the director of the series, renowned director of hashtag Y, X with Benefits, Love Me Tomorrow, and siyempre, Ang Sin Island. Next up, we have Marcus Patterson. Marcus Patterson's outfit is inspired by Michael Jackson, the OG.
Marcus plays as Jude. Jude is Zoe's former singing partner before Jude left for the US to take his music career to the next level. At present, he is a famous artist. Let's go! Next up, we have Aljon Mendoza. Aljon Mendoza for today's Thursday. He's wearing, his outfit is inspired by Justin Bieber. Aljon as Ice is a breadwinner. Ice is a hustler who juggles many jobs to keep his family afloat. A natural songwriter and producer, he is also a band leader who wants to win the music jam to support his sick sister. Alright, ito na. We have our last actor. We have Jayla. Woo! Jayla's outfit is inspired by Taylor Swift. Jayla as Zoe. Zoe is a former cover artist and online singing sensation who wants to continue pursuing her dream as she enters college. Despite her mom's apprehension, she is determined to fulfill her wish to her dead musician father. Let's go, Zoe! And lastly, mga kapamilya, I'd like to acknowledge ABS-CBN Film Production Incorporated. And we would like to share the celebration with Idangs, the writer of the famous online novel. Itong novel na to, which inspired the series. So Idang, hello to you and thank you so much for your contribution, your thought process, and your creative ideas. And also, we would like to give a shout out to Miss Kukai, the creative manager of Black Sheep and head writer of Team Clash. All right, everyone. So, alam naman natin. Alam naman natin that this cast is very talented and very good looking as well. So, of course, kasama naman sa MediaCon natin na may kasamang surprises na inaabangan din ng lahat. So let's call on the talented Jayla, who will perform an original song entitled Perfectly Imperfect.
Well, una-una po sa lahat. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Thank you so much for being here to support us, the Teen Clash cast. Kaya naman po, this next song is for all of you.
Say it.
top. Let's start from the top. Let's start from the top. Okay. Let's cut the track. Start from the top. Nice. Let's go. Hey.
Kasama na rin ako dyan. At syempre, kasama rin kayo dito. Ang official trailer ng Team Clash. But, before we show the trailer and we share it with you guys, I'd like to invite the cast na imbitahin lahat ng mga tao na manood ng Teen Clash na darating na yung March 17. We can start with the creatives or direct Gino Santos.
I'm inviting everyone to watch Teen Clash this March 17. You know, the kids worked so hard on this, the creatives, everyone. We're so happy and excited and proud for you guys to watch this on March 17. Thank you so much. Everyone, the kids, Jada, invite everyone.
Yes, well, una-una po sa lahat. Like I said earlier, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat for being here today to support us and this project. Sobrang ano, pinakahirapan talaga namin to. And sana po magustuhan niyo po yung output na to, lalo na yung trailer. And of course, I think it's just we all feel super grateful to be here today. And sana po talaga na ma-appreciate niyo po to.
All right, Marcus, would you want to invite everyone to invite Teen Clash?
Of course, hello everyone. Maraming maraming salamat sa oras and the time that you've given us today. We really appreciate it. We really cannot wait for you guys to see and enjoy the show that we have enjoyed so much making. So yeah, sana na enjoy mo yung trailer ngayon. And of course, March 17 na po, Teen Clash.
Aljon, let's have you next, bro.
Hi po, kamusta po kayong lahat dyan? Okay pa po kayo? Ayan. Una-una sa lahat, syempre, maraming salamat sa pagbigay nyo ng oras para sa media con natin today. Sobrang na-appreciate namin yun. At maraming salamat sa mga nanonood ngayon. Sana magustuhan nyo ang trailer at sana abangan nyo ang Teen Clash this March 17. Thank you.
Alright, there we go. So, ito na mga pamilya. Let us play the full official trailer of Teen Clash.
People always say, when one door closes, another one opens.
One, two, three!
But when it finally opened, TBH, I wish it never did.
Miss!
Dalawang klase lang ng tao meron sa mundo. May ibang hulog ng langit, at iba naman na nahulog sa akin. Pero bakit siya pa?
This is it, the moment I've been praying for. Everyone has their own dreams.
Paano kung audition natin to? Anong ginagawa ng mga chicks nato dito?
And we'll do everything to reach it.
Pwede ba tayo mag-usap?
She's in a strong, independent moment now.
Sabihin mo, inagaw mo siya para masira yung banda namin.
Hey, guys! Mas magaling kayo kung mag-merge kayo together.
And the plot thickens.
Save mo yung number mo para mapag-usapan natin sa presentation.
Pero wag mo akong matext-text nang kumain na ba you?
Huwag kang feeling.
Don't tell me crush mo si Zoe.
Oh, dati, okay? Pag iba na siya ngayon.
What? Palaban. Kahit din niya laban, ilalaban niya para sa'yo.
Sino ba yung Zoe na yan, ha? Zoe David po. Medyo skandalosa lang. Kung ano-anong mga sinasabi ng mga tao sa'yo, meron ba nagsabi sa'yo magaling kang kumanta? Ni isang wala!
We may fall on our faces,
but we will always get back up.
That's why I'm going all out.
Chill lang. Darating din yan.
What if sakyan na lang natin yung cheese face? Is that possible?
Ano possible?
Will you be my boyfriend?
Love us
or hate us,
we don't give a fuck.
Yeah. All right, guys. So, quick trivia lang that I learned earlier. Like, where we are right now, dito sila nag-shooting ng No Name Bar sa series nila. So, wala lang, nakaka-starstruck. Fun trivia lang. And of course, since that was the official trailer, sa lahat ng mga kapamilya natin na nakatutok na yun sa ating live stream on ABS-CBN and I Want TFC, don't forget to like, comment, and share the trailer to spread awareness na darating na po ang Teen Clash this March 17. Ayun po. Alright, so now that we've seen the trailer, let's get the reactions of the cast. Kung anong reaction nila first time seeing the trailer. We could start with anyone. Luke?
Ako, sobra akong happy nung nakita namin yung trailer. Kasi syempre, yun yung pinaghirapan namin ng mga cast. And nakakatuwa kasi unti-unti na siya nabubuo. And sobra akong blessed kasi nabigyan ako ng opportunity para makasama itong mga malulupit at mga rakista namin kasama. And sobra akong happy. Thank you.
Alright, next up, let's have Fano.
Ako naman po, sobrang nakaka-proud talaga kasi ayun nga, katulad ng sabi ni Luke, ito na finally yung pinaghirapan namin. And since ito nga din po yung first acting experience ko, sobrang happy ako and it's such an honor na makasama po ang the whole cast and of course, ang buong team. Ayan.
Ako na ba?
Alright, next up, let's have V. Marcus Patterson.
Grabe naman yung sa V, bro. all I can say is sobra akong proud sa cast na to. The kids, like, just seeing them put in their heart and their effort into every scene they do. And considering the fact that not a lot of them were experienced in acting, this is Jada's first acting project. As Fana said, it's her first acting project. Hindi halata. Everyone here is so talented and committed to this show, and I can't wait for you guys to see that.
Alright, so ngayon, nalaman namin na nakatutok ang mga kapamilya at mga netizens natin and mga clashmates natin in our online streaming services on our live stream sa ABS-CBN, I Want TFC, and Black Sheep na rin. We have 5,000 viewers right now, so don't forget to comment, like, and share the live stream so a lot of people can know about Clash Teen. Naabang na po this March 17 na po yan. Kaabang-abang po mga kapamilya. And during the viewing of the making of Clash Teen, what I like about this is that it's a wide spectrum of characters, di ba? May iba't ibang characters dito, may kanyang-kanyang hugot, may kanyang-kanyang karga na talagang tinadala nila sa series na to. And on top of that, I also like na everyone's like really just having a good time, a fun time as well, and iba pa rin yung market to the Gen Z. But I'm sure that the stories here are relatable sa iba't ibang social classes, sa iba't ibang social ages and groups as well. So I'm really excited about that. And you know, I was able to see the cast earlier as well, talk to some of them, and sobrang halata na they really have this chemistry and this really natural bond that can just really alleviate the project and make their whole essence come through the screen. And for sure, sure na makikita niyo po yan through your screens with Clash Teen as well. And of course, with the creatives, with all the directors putting all in their hard work, it's really something to really look forward to. And I'm just so excited for this. And now, we can have our question and answer. All right, so let's ask the cast. Let's ask the cast right now. Let's start with whoever wants to answer. Hey guys. So the question is, personally, I really want to know, what is the happiest thing or what is your favorite moment filming the series of Teen Clash? Like top of your head.
I mean,
let's start with, okay, Jada?
I guess, sobrang daming mga moments na sobrang happy kasi nga, I feel like we're all naturally really close, pero I think it's the pranks that would go on before we would do takes, specifically one time with Ralph, where he was late. Si Kobe nakaisip nun eh. Pero yun, like, some... pero yun nga, I would say yung mga pranks, pati yung mga moments na... Alam mo yun, pag those moments on set na for example, may nabubulol or something like that. Aljon, for instance. For instance, you know, I guess the beautiful thing about it is we all just kind of like are able to laugh it off and just really have fun and enjoy. So, siguro yun yung mga moments na ganun. And yung mga moments of improv, siguro yung mga pag nag-a-adlib yung mga classmates namin, it's super hilarious. So, ayun.
Ako naman. ang akin naman, kay Ralph din. Ewan ko, nakakatawa talaga si Ralph eh. May scene kami. May scene kami na susugurin namin sina Zoe at yung girls, kaming mga boys. Tapos, may moment doon na si Ralph, bigla siyang nag... Gawin mo nga, Ralph, yung...
Mag-i-spoil.
Hindi, yung... pinakita naman eh.
No!
Tapos lahat kami, parang pinipigilan namin yung tawa namin. Pero may nakailang takes kami doon direk eh, di ba?
Mga 4 takes ata eh. Pinipigilan na tumawa. So yun yung challenge dito, no? To keep yourself in character while everyone's doing something silly. So yun yung ginagawa nila. And minsan nagagawa, minsan hindi. But I'm happy for them, no? They're really trying to keep a straight face. It's really a light set.
It was out of nowhere then. That really caught us off guard, so parang that was the funniest thing ever.
Yun.
At saka yung ano...
Ay, sorry.
Dadagdag lang ako. Sorry. Yung kapag kunyari mga 1 AM na, parang dun talaga gumagana yung mga utak namin. And lahat parang sobrang hyper, sobrang energetic. Parang let's do this. Parang gawin na natin to. And parang hindi kami napapagod kasi kung ano-ano na lang yung mga sinasabi namin. And ayun, masaya siyang gawin kasama tong mga cast sa Team Cash. Kaya, guys, solid nyo. I love you all.
Love you.
Well, there we go. Now, I'd like to introduce Sir Justin Iron to help us entertain questions from our respected and reputable guest, the lovely press. Nakasama po natin na yun.
Ayan, maraming salamat sa'yo, Jello. It was so nice to meet you. Ang galing. Ayan. We have a lot of questions from the media in store for our cast members of Team Clash. Okay, umpisahan na natin. By the way, I'm Justin Irons from EBSBN PR. Ayan. Una, gusto ko magpasalamat to our friends from the media for, especially to those who na nag-stay up to this point. Alam namin, sunod-sunod ang events ninyo ngayong araw. Ayan. Alright, sige, umpisahan na natin our first set of questions. Iabot ko po ang mic. From Alan Sancon of Stars Photog.
Ayan na.
Hi. Congratulations everyone. Dinig ba? Parang may
thank you, thank you, sir.
Salamat po.
Congratulations for your new series, musical series. Ang first question ko for Jada.
Yes po.
Yeah. No po. So Jada, I don't know if it is tama ako na this is your first acting.
Opo, it is.
Kumbaga, how is it? How is it itong first series mo? Kinabahan ka ba? Did you ask advice from your parents sa pareho namang uma-acting before? And nakilala ka namin before sa music eh, di ba? So this time, how is it doing this series for the first time?
Oo naman po, syempre tao lang po ako. Syempre kinabahan din po ako. May kasamang pressure pero honestly po na-challenge po ako and this is something new for me. And it's such a wonderful first experience and first project for me po. To be with all of these amazing people na lahat po kami committed po sa isang goal which is makapagpasaya ng tao through this medium which is through this series. And syempre po, nag-ask din po ako ng advice sa magulang ko, specifically my mom since she's been acting since she was 11 years old. So syempre yun, pero I guess I also seeked help from, of course, ABS-CBN. And management, of course, sila Direk Gina, sila Ati Kukay, and the writers as well of this amazing series to, I guess, you know, help me find the direction of where to take this role and this project. So it's honestly been such an amazing experience and fun. I feel really grateful po kasi para po sa akin, parang na-marry po yung dalawang worlds ko po ng music and of course acting, which is a newfound passion for me. So, dream project po talaga siya.
Follow up lang, saan mo gustong makilala? Being a good singer or being a good actress?
Ako po, I would like to be known as a multimedia entertainer. I guess whichever, however people will know me. Pero syempre po, ito po, masasabi ko po, music will always be my first love. And nandun po talaga yung puso ko. Pero syempre po, there's also room in my heart for acting. And especially with this project. And yun nga po, gaya po ng sinabi ko po. I guess I'm able to showcase two new sides to myself. And of course, one part about me, which is of course my music background. Pero ito po, yung acting po. Salamat po.
And this role is perfect for her because she sings and acts. And the role requires her to sing in this series. And kuwang-kuwa ni Jada yung character na Zoe.
Salamat po, Direk.
Direk, nasa iyo na rin yung spot. Tanongin na rin kita.
Oh yes,
kumbaga,
go ahead.
Kumbaga, paano na buo tong series na to? This is a musical series, di ba? Kumbaga talagang yung mga makakasali dito dapat magaling kumanta, magaling sa music, may ganun ba? Because this is a musical series.
Well, it's not a musical, but madaming music dito, no? They're a band, they play instruments. But yes, we auditioned all of them. Lahat sila may instrument and musical capabilities. Some sing, some can play the drums, the guitar. So we had auditions and ayan, nandito na ang Team Clash ano natin, stars natin.
Sundutan ko lang yung talok ni Direk. Ang lakas ng mic ko. Ayan, so Direk, you had to check their musical ability before you make them a cast. That's a requirement.
Yes, can you sing? Can you play an instrument? And sa auditions, they were auditioning para kaming ano, para kaming idol ano na buzzer ganyan. But lahat sila nandiyan, they had their own particular style and you know, personality na nagustuhan namin for this show.
So masasabi nyo direct na well-deserved based dun sa talent na pinakita nila?
Of course, of course. They wouldn't be here and the show wouldn't be complete. And you know, nakita nyo naman ang the making and yung trailer, no? Mukha talaga silang banda at magkaibigan na banda.
Okay. Yung second question ko for Aljon. Hi, Aljon.
Hi po.
This is a new this is a new pair, love team, di ba? Parang nanibago kami na parang wala si Karina ngayon. Your new love team is Jada. So how is it working with Jada? And kumbaga, paano yun? Parang nanibago ka ba because you have a new love team now? Parang ganun.
Hi. Speechless agad. Nung nalaman po namin na magkakaroon kami ng project together, talagang kinilala namin yung isa't isa. We started texting each other. Inaalam ko yung hobbies niya, yung hobbies ko, yung mga kung paano namin tingnan yung mga bagay. So, maraming effort yung ginagawa namin para mag-work itong project. So, parang before pa nung taping, ang dami na nung goals natin na gusto nating magawa. And sobrang collaborative kasi every time may scene kami, tinutulungan niya talaga ako. Halimbawa, may scene na madaling araw, tapos parang lowbat ako. Papahawak lang ako sa kamay niya. Tapos, yun, feeling ko. Ako kasi yung love language ko, physical. So, every time may hahawak sa kamay ko, parang nafe-feel ko yung energy. Parang nare-recharge ako. So, napag-usapan din namin yung strengths and weaknesses namin, strategic kami mag-isip. And every time may kailangan din siya na tulong from me sa scene, minomotivate ko din siya. So na-appreciate ko yun sa kanya kasi willing siya to work with me. Since yung trust pa lang, syempre debut niya to, debut acting tapos launching project niya, pinagkakatiwalaan niya ako doon. Sobrang thankful ako. Ayun.
Yung nakita naman sa trailer, di ba? Isa sa mga eksena na kaabang-abang yung eksena nyo dun sa topless scene mo. So, is there any pressure dun sa part na yon? And paano nyo pinagandaan yon? Meron bang ilangan dun sa eksena na yon, di ba?
Ay, marami pa pong magta-topless dito sa Teen Clash. abangan nyo po kasi hindi lang yun yung topless. I mean, si Zach, si Kobe nag... Basta yun, abangan nyo guys. May pressure kasi ako, kailangan ko mag-workout eh. Kailangan ko, dapat wala akong taba dito. Pero best effort, nagawa naman namin siya ng fun and kung paano siya nakikita ni Direk. Ayun, tinutungan talaga kami ni Direk sa mga topless scene.
At ano naman kayo, confident naman lahat kayo, no? Such a good-looking cast, no? Kahit anong shape and size sila, they still look good because of their confidence.
Body positivity.
Body positivity. Parang hindi yata nag-topless si Kobe doon na, doon sa trailer. I don't know kung magta-topless ba siya doon.
Bata pa ako. No, but yeah, I think I'll just save that for another time. I'll just save my body muna.
Sana sinabi mo na abangan namin, di ba?
Opo, abangan nyo lang po.
Yung last ko na lang for ano, Jada.
Ano po? Sorry po. Yeah.
Jada, parang ano, big word yung sinabi ni Aljon na malaki yung support mo sa kanya by holding his hand. Parang ganon. Buti parang okay lang. Parang hindi ilang on your part na, di ba parang it's intimidating na maka-holding yung isang guy na bago mo palang ka-love team, ganun. Parang, paano mo i-handle yung situation na yan?
I think po, ang masasabi ko po talaga na I really do trust him. And I think yun talaga yung foundation ng working relationship namin. And yung approach namin na bago pa po namin talaga mag-start dito sa project na to, we really developed our friendship. And dahil rin po, ramdam ko po talaga na committed din po siya dito sa project na to. And we're all working, and we're both working towards one goal. I think yun talaga, syempre may mga moments na, syempre tao lang din tayo, may ilangan ng kote. Pero I think nawala din yun eventually. And mas nagiging, I think habang mas nagkakatrabaho po kami, mas nagiging komportable po kami sa isa't isa. And dahil yun nga po, I do feel like, dahil nga po, we're working towards one goal, wala pong parang feeling of discomfort or anything like that po. So, yun nga po, tiwala lang po talaga.
Okay. Thank you and congratulations to your new musical series.
Salamat po.
Thank you po.
Thank you.
Ayan, salamat Kuya Alan. Ako, bago ko tatawagin yung susunod na magtatanong, I'm just curious, no? Bawat isa sa inyo, I've seen you in several projects, whether on I Want or EBS-CBN. How is this project different from what you did previously? I mean, ilang taon pa lang kayo sa industriya, pero parang ang dami-dami nyo nang nagawang series. Sila Kobe, si Andy, si Zach. Ikaw, sige, umpisa natin kay Andy.
Well, hello. Hi, everyone. First of all, gusto ko muna magpasalamat, of course, sa press natin and sa buong team na nag-set up dito sa AMRAC. And sobrang different ng project na to for me because it's my first time to be in a triangle and in an interesting triangle pa. It's not like the usual triangle that you watch in Philippine films and series. Iba siya. So, yun po yung difference niya. And I'm really excited because I was really challenged kung paano ko ba ipapakita yung kilig and yung chemistry ko for both of my pairs here sa triangle.
So yung bago mong ka-pair ay si...
Si Sab, si Fana. Fana nga. Si Sab.
May adjustment ka ba? Kasi you know, I know you're used to Kobe. How about with Zach? May adjustment ka ba?
Oh no, si Fana po yung kabila ko pong ka-pair here. Of course, there's an adjustment. I would have to like really break down some walls on how we could work on our chemistry together. And it's not just like me and Fana or like me and Kobe alone, but it's like us three talaga. And that it takes a lot of work for us to make that chemistry appear on screen.
All right, thank you for sharing. Ikaw.
Yeah, I just want to say hello to all the press. Thank you so much for coming out today and giving your time to us. And thank you to the whole staff that set this up. And anyways, going back to the question, para sa akin po, ang difference po dito sa project to, syempre naman, I had to build the chemistry. Well, we're a big group. We're a big band together. So I had to build my chemistry with everyone. Syempre, I have my best friends here, like Zach and Aljon and Ralph. So we had to build our chemistry as a group. And especially, lalo na sa love triangle po, you know, it's very different, but it's exciting and fun as well. So yeah, I think that's the biggest difference for me.
Your most recent project before this is
Love in 40 Days po.
Oh, Love in 40 Days. Ayan. Ikaw naman, Zach.
Hello, mic test. Yun. Hello, guys.
I would say na this project is very different from the last project I did. Kasi nung the last project I did was Tara G, no? If you guys, you know, heard of it, no? Oh. And as a local Laguertan, parang I had to change up a lot, but not really. Kasi my character as Will from Tara G is kind of similar to my character here as Sander. Except, you know, Sander's more, what we call that, more alpha male, no? So, yun. And another difference is, it's music, parang, it's musical in a way. So, those are
the sabi ni Derek that you were challenged, your musical ability was challenged.
Actually, super duper challenging yung eksena namin when we sing. Kasi, of course, parang we have to choreograph it perfectly. And, you know, kasi when I did my scene, I was going wild at it. So, it was really, really hard. Pero at the same time, parang it's an experience kasi, I don't know, parang it kind of reminded me of High School Musical. And, you know, I really love High School Musical as a child, no? So, parang, I don't know, it's really nice. And I'm just excited to see the outcome of it. And, yeah, I'm really stoked.
Okay, dito ang talent na pinapapakita mo ay dancing ba?
Singing. Yeah.
Kayo guys, si Andy and Kobe. Eski, para lang malaman natin yung roles ng bawat isa.
Drumming, tsaka, guitar.
Well, I hindi po ako bandmate here, so I'm the waitress of No Name. I'm fangirling.
Ah,
that's
okay.
My
as
talent
fangirl.
Here.
Okay. Okay, ikaw naman. What was your most recent project?
First and foremost, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Ako po si Bianca. Thank you so much for being here. I haven't done much. I'm very new to this industry. This is actually the second one I've ever filmed. So, I guess I would say she's very different from me as Bianca in general. Kasi Yani, she loves differently from me. She is very, very musically inclined. She plays the piano, so there are certain things that I had to learn for her, like let's say the piano. So, si Ate Kukay, before taping, tinuruan niya ako, mga dalawang oras kami doon. And,
wow.
As in, tatlo or dalawang keys lang tinuturong niya sa akin, tapos paulit-ulit. So, yeah, she's very, very different from me, but she's very close to my heart because in a way, naiintindihan ko siya kung bakit siya ganun, kung bakit siya mataray, kung bakit ang sungit-sungit niya. But yet, she still gives the world to the people that she loves. So, ayun. Yan lang po masasabi ko. Thank you.
Thank you. Ikaw naman, Marcus, parang viral scandal ba yung last mo? Or you did several projects?
I've done a couple more after viral scandal, pero hindi pa sila out. So yeah, I'm just gonna say viral scandal was the last, yeah.
So anong na-challenge ka ba dito coming from like a hit teleserye?
I wouldn't say challenged. I felt more excited because it's very different from most of the roles that I've done in the past. Mas parang seryoso yung approach ng career path ko before. So Teen Clash was a bit of an unexpected jolt, but it's a very welcomed unexpected jolt. I really 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 enjoyed the whole process of getting casted here in this show as Jude, coincidentally.
Oh nga, napansin namin. Was that intentional or?
It's in the book, so coincidence lang. So,
coincidence.
But yeah, it's great. It's a very light and it's a great way to start the year, get to know all these amazing casts and creatives and Direk Gino, everyone. It's been awesome. It's been really really good.
First time mo ba sila makatrabaho or you worked with them before?
Si Aljun kasama ko sa viral scandal.
Oo nga.
Pero yeah, first time ko with everyone. Not with Black Sheep. Ay, ata with Black Sheep. They will know. They'll know. Ata.
So dito, anong musical na talent ang makikita namin from you?
Guitar tsaka vocals ako dito. So para hindi ako kasama sa mga banda. I'm more of a solo artist. Yeah. Pero dating singing partner ni Zoe na biglang bumalik lang para lang sirain yung yung love team. Magugulo lang ako dito.
Very exciting, abangan natin yan. Dumako tayo doon sa side na to. Alam natin yung iba sa kanila, parang mga singers talaga. So yun, can you introduce yourself, then your role in the series? Ayan. Ayan, sige, umpisa
okay.
Natin.
Hi everyone, my name is Gail. Thank you so much for spending your time here with us. I play the role of Ayumi, and she's an energetic math genius na medyo masungit, but also parang may pakakalog din, as I said. But yeah, it's really fun working with everyone. But I have to say, one of the things that makes this experience so different compared to mga previous na projects ko is the freedom, siguro. Kasi yung mga directors that I used to work with before, they're very based on the script. You have to follow everything. Pero sobrang na-challenge ako dito kasi si Direk Gino, he keeps saying, just do whatever you want, just have fun and everything. And I'm not used to that. But ngayon, I'm, you know, super blessed to have this experience. And yeah, Teen Clash is amazing, guys. So I hope you support it. Thank you.
Ayan, how about you?
Yes, hello po everyone. Maraming salamat po sa pagpunta po dito. Ako nga po pala si Ralph Malibunas. And ang piniplay po ng character ko po dito na instrument is guitar po. And yung character ko po dito is matalino. Ibang-iba po talaga siya. And medyo challenging po siya sa akin kasi hindi naman po talaga ako matalino in real life. Pero thank you sa salamin kasi nagmukha po akong matalino, di ba? Pero ayun po, syempre sa tulong po nila Direk, nagabayan naman po nila ako kung paano po gawin yung character ni Ken. And ayun po, masaya po siyang gawin dahil parang naglalaro lang din po kami sa set dahil sobrang enjoy. Kaya, ayun, must watch. Let's go.
Hi everyone, maraming salamat po for being here. And I'm Fana and I'm playing the role of Sab, Zoe's cool friend. And I'm a lesbian po dito and childhood best friend ni Josh. And ayun, I'm really excited for this kasi this is my first acting experience. And noong una po talaga, actually, sobrang kinabahan ako kasi since ito nga po yung una kong experience. But of course, with the help of Direk and the cast and the whole team, natulungan po nila ako na magawa po itong role na to. Kaya masaya ako dahil talagang para lang kami nagbabonding. And super masaya siya. And I'm drummer po pala ako dito. Drummer, yes.
So yun, magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Ako po si Luke Alford. And ako po si Lloyd po dito sa Teen Clash, yung best friend po ni Ice. Ayan, so ang kinaibahan po ng last project ko po dito po sa Teen Clash is, last project ko po is The Chosen One sa Pie Channel. And sobra po siyang heavy, iyakan, ganyan. And patayan, mga ganun pong type of ano of show po. Tapos dito po kasi is very light. And dun po ako na challenge kasi parang nasanay po ako na hindi po snappy yung pagbabato ng linya kasi dapat kailangan merong reaction. So yun po sinasabi sa akin ni Direk Gino. And tinutulungan naman po ako ni Direk Gino, inalalayan ako and sa mga staff na unti-unting i-improve po yung pagiging snappy kasi syempre dapat mabilis. Ganyan. So yun po, pinaka na challenge po ako dun. Yeah, thank you po.
Ayan. Maraming salamat. Thank you for sharing about your characters. Bago ako magpatuloy, I've a lot of questions and our friends from the media, marami rin silang tanong. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of my boss from ABS-CBN Corporate Communications, the head of ABS-CBN Corporate Communications, Mr. Kane Errol Choa. Hi, sir. Ayan. Salamat po. All right, sige. Itutuloy ko na yung tanong. Direk, marami akong question kay Direk. Direk, tawag dito, parang yun niya, everyone seemed to have fun while filming the series. Kayo rin mismo, parang the creatives and the director, parang mga cool kayong person. Ano bang style niyo? Can you share with us? Not really the typical that we see.
Yes, yes. Not everyone knows that I came from the coming of age genre nung nag-i-indie pa ako back in Cinemalaya. So I did Animals, hashtag Y. So sanay ako working with young actors, no? Most of the time they're starting pa lang. So I always tell them, no, don't go far from what you know. Kasi syempre college students sila. So ako naman, I don't want to limit their acting. I want them to do what they know. And of course, syempre, alam na nila yan. So, sabi ko sa nila, just enjoy the role. So, may nakikita kong mga bago. Kapag nag-i-improv sila, mas gumaganda, mas nagiging nakakatawa yung scene, at mas nagiging totoo. That's why I'm so excited for the Gen Zs to watch it. Kasi they'll see a bit of themselves in each and every character. So, yun. And of course, our writers are very young as well. Na si Polly and si Simon and si Kukay, kaya lumilitaw talaga ang pagka-Gen Z. Diba, Gen Z?
Yeah, Slay.
here. Thank you, Derek. And what do you think sets this apart from the other? Kasi iWant has launched, I think, in the past 2 years, several teen-oriented shows, some of them musically inclined din. This one, what sets it, this apart?
This one is produced also by Black Sheep. No, what we've seen from Black Sheep, very edgy, you know, out of the box stories. And this one talaga, magugulat kayo pag makita niyo. Just from the trailer alone and the making, you see those things even in the bathroom scene na, whoa, pwede pala yung makita sa TV, no, or sa series. And for this one, you know, the characters can swear, they can drink. They have urges, so let's see what happens sa mga episodes natin.
Very interesting. Aabangan namin yan. Ikaw, Jello, may question ka ba sa kanila before I call on our next media na magtatanong?
Question. Siguro for the whole cast or whoever wants to answer, what is like the, with your characters and everything, ano yung... hugot ninyo sa roles niyo that you play? And throughout the progression of the show, do we see your character evolve or stagnant ba siya? Or like, how did you take on this?
Ayan, Jello, bago nila sagutin yan, we'd like to acknowledge lang the presence of the head of ABS-CBN Films, Mr. Chris Gasman. Woo! Good afternoon po, sir. Ayan, go ahead.
Ayan, yung mga hugot ng characters nyo. Jada.
Yeah, siguro ano, I would start off with, sobrang nagre-resonate ako kay Zoe. I would say na, you know, one of the driving forces with her is that she craves validation. And I think a lot of artists can relate to that na, yung feeling na yun na artists do crave for validation to a certain extent. And she just wants to be seen. She wants people to appreciate her for her talent. And sa totoo lang po, nakikita ko din yung mga aspects ng younger self ko po kay Zoe. Yung kapal na mukha ni Zoe, ganun din po ako nung bata ako. So, yun, I would say yung personal hugot ko is, I really looked into my core as a person and seeing as how I could relate to her. And hindi po naging mahirap po yun para sa akin. And I guess I would say that it's a really good... character to really start with, hindi po siya nalalayo po sa personality ko po and sa mga goals ko and my personality in real life.
Yeah, and thank you, Jada, for sharing.
Thank you so much, Jada. But before we proceed, we'd like to acknowledge the ABS-CBN head for digital, Sir Jamie Lopez! Hello, Sir Jamie. Thank you so much.
Ayan. Oh, very interesting yung sinabi ni Jada, hindi nalalayo sa character niya. And a lot of your fans would like to know you more. Kaya talaga namang aabangan nila your role in Teen Clash. Anyone else who would like to answer? Ano bang hugot niyo sa role? Ayan, sige, Alzon. Anong hugot mo sa role?
Ang character ko dito ay si Ice. Ang pinaka-hugot niya ay love is a scam. So, kahit love yan sa... romantic or sa family or kahit kanino. So, ako naman kasi sa personal kong buhay, kapag ina-acting ko si... pag binibigyan kong buhay si Ice sa eksena, hindi kasi talaga lahat ng pinagdaanan ko sa buhay ay tutugma sa script or pinagdaanan din ni Ice. So, may mga bagay na tinutugma ko siya kapag nakaka-relate ako. At may mga bagay na... kinikilala ko talaga yung character. Binibuild ko yung kung anong relationship niya sa nanay niya, okay Zoe, or sa bandmates niya. Kasi somehow nagme-method din kami. Kasi parang gumagawa kami ng connection off-cam na hindi naman talaga kailangan sabihin sa amin. Kumbaga nagkakaroon kami ng kusa na magkaroon ng connection and relationship sa isa't isa. Ayun po.
Very nice. Masasabi mo bang love is a scam sa totoong buhay?
Sa totoong buhay, siyempre hindi ko ginajudge yung character ko kasi pinagdaanan niya yun, nire-respect ko. Pero sa personal kong pananaw, hindi naman scam ang love. Ayan.
Ayan, okay. Ramdam naman namin. Kami nga kinikilig din. Alright, sige, bago natin ubusin yung mga tanong, no? I'd like to call on our second question from starcinema.com. We have Yumi Javier. Pahiram po ng mic.
Hi, Miss Yumi.
Hi, guys. Huge congratulations. We've been waiting for this series for so long.
Thank you.
Now it's here. Thank you, Ms. Yumi. So my first question is for Direct Gino. I have a couple of questions for the whole cast, and anyone and everyone can answer. But Direct, a lot of hit teen series now, especially in Hollywood, like Euphoria and Wednesday, they've been tackling like really hard issues, like brave when it comes to tackling issues that we don't normally see. And while Teen Clash seems to have that trademark, kilig, lovable vibes that Filipinos are used to and love, how is it breaking the barriers in terms of telling the stories of Filipino young adults, whether 90s kids or Gen Zs?
I think the young ones now, no, the general theme is also finding yourself, finding your dreams, and also lifting up yourself after a scandal. Alam mo na, uso na yung cancel culture. So we'll see in this series how you put up yourself, no? Pick up yourself from the ground after being canceled. So ganyan yung makikita natin sa mga characters natin sa show na to.
Wow, okay, so cancel culture is one of the main themes. All right. For the whole cast naman, we're interested to know, many viewers and fans are interested to know, your main musical inspiration for your character.
I guess I'll start then. Well, siguro po, I would say that one of my main musical inspirations when it comes to music in general, even for myself, would be Taylor Swift, of course. As you can see, I am wearing a Taylor Swift-inspired outfit. But I think I really channeled into really strong, empowered female pop icons or even rock icons. So I was listening to artists like Avril Lavigne, Olivia Rodrigo, Maisie Peters, who's an up-and-coming British singer-songwriter, and just all these women who have something to say with their music, and which is something that I resonate with my own music as well. And so I think that's really what I wanted to channel in with Zoe's drive and passion when it comes to anything, and of course her dreams.
All right, any of the cast?
Sige, I'll answer. I don't have a specific musician that I gained inspiration from, pero I gained inspiration from a lot of rockers. Eh. And another good thing about on set is whenever it's break time, si Direct Gino would always leave his laptop to make me watch movies, mga coming of age movies specifically, mga early 2000s stuff. I try to gain inspiration from that, and I gain inspiration from your typical rockers, like Rolling Stones and stuff like that. And parang I kind of manifested it pretty well naman, no? So, yun. It's a little hard to answer a specific musician, pero I would say it's like a bunch. And I just combine everyone and then yun.
Zach here is the biggest movie buff here. He watches my laptop. Nakatutok lang siya. And pinapanood namin sa kanya mga Tagalog movies like Trip, Jologs. So, mahanap rin sa I Want.
Actually, I appreciate that nga, Direk. Kasi parang, when I watch those coming-of-age movies, before my take or before my scene, I have that inspiration. Eh. And I told Direk Gino about that specifically. And it works. I really carry the character of Sander. So, yeah. Yun lang.
Anyone else?
Yeah, anyone else who'd like to share your musical inspiration? Si Fana siguro.
Ako naman po, inspiration ko. Just like what Jada and said, nakikinig po ako sa maraming artists. And siguro yung inspiration ko, parents ko po. Kasi yung parents ko, tumugtog sila sa isang band. So, tinuturuan nila ako. And ayun po, sila po yung inspiration ko siguro, yeah.
Actually, I also have one. My inspiration would have to be, she's not very famous here, pero her name is Upsol. And the way that she writes, she has a very, I don't give a F attitude about everything. And having to be, Zoe's friend in this, diba? We have to be very strong and like energetic and very opinionated women, you know, to carry the band. So I try to channel her when I channel Ayumi.
All right. Okay, thank you. That makes it more exciting for us to watch how these inspirations translate on screen. And my last question would be, in relation to the whole storyline of the series, what was the hardest personal challenge that you've had to face as a teen or as a young adult, and how did you overcome it?
Medyo, I miss you.
Pang Miss Universe yung tanong eh.
Who would like to start?
Marcus. Go, Marcus.
I mean, the hardest, as a teen,
as a teen.
As a teen or a young adult. I've been writing songs and singing songs and writing since 5 years ago, I think I started here. But one thing I never really got over was performing live. That's always been a fear of mine. And what I'm excited for you guys to see is that I'm actually going to be putting myself out there in this show. I know it's taping and stuff, but still, that's probably my biggest fear that I'm going to overcome throughout this show, performing live. And even public speaking, nabubulong nga ako minsan sa mga press ko, pero, you know, it's a big thing of mine and I can't wait for you guys to see.
Ako po, I think yung biggest challenge ko as a teen or kahit as a child before, I've always been away from my family. Like, we all don't live together, you know. As a kid, I never really got to live with my dad. It was always just me and my mom, sister. And it was never easy just being away from family all the time. That's why I really cherish the moments when I get to see them, because I don't get to see them that much. Lalo na yung tatay ko at yung kuya ko. So, probably one of the biggest challenges for me as a teen.
I'd like to follow up Kobe's answer. As a former teen, no, since I'm like, you know, 23, I would say the most challenging part is independency. I would like to say na sobrang overwhelming yung adult life, and I felt it. It was really, it's a weird experience. Parang when I turned 20, 21, when I started making my own money, no? Parang, shucks, it's like I'm already, I'm working. Parang I remember as a child, I would always think of my adult self and I'll be like, I'm gonna, like, you know, I'll do good and stuff like that. But when I turned into, you know, when I turned 20, I was like, okay, wait lang. This is a little bit overwhelming. Parang new territories, it's not my comfort zone. Pero you get that satisfying feeling once you overcome that. Eh. Like, for example, social anxiety, no? Usually, when you're young, parang you tend to be scared to talk in front of people. Those little steps lang of you overcoming it really, really motivates me to work harder and become a better person as well. So, yan. And Bianca?
I'd like to add lang sa sinabi ni Zach about independency. I think, habang tumatanda tayo as teenagers, diba, parang you really have to acknowledge na hindi na tayo bata. We have to stand on our own feet. Our parents won't be here forever and we have to find our place in this world. So, I think ang hindi naiintindihan ng iba is that we are in a constant search of filling a certain void in our hearts. So, yun for me yung mahirap is that ano bang purpose natin? Are we happy? Are we... Parang alam mo yung ganong feeling. But like, I'm over that na. Okay na. Masayang-masaya po ako as in sobra.
May existential crisis na nagaganap.
Yeah. Nung...
It's okay. Don't you think that's an advantage? Like, kasi diba some other kids or teens na hirapan silang kumawala sa parents na nakakasakal, ganyan. Hindi ba yung having given an independence at a young age, hindi ba mas parang, ano yun, masaya?
Tsaka I think it's a cultural thing as a Filipino, no? Parang we tend to stay with our families a lot longer than, you know, the people from the West, no? Sa States. Kasi usually, people in the West, they would start working mga 16 years old, 15 years old. But I'm not assuming na most young Filipinos are like that. Ah. Kasi I know a lot of, I have a lot of friends that worked at a very young age and I really respect them for that. And yun, I think an advice for everyone, for all the Gen Zers, is to parang try to find work, try to be independent at an early age. Kasi you're not gonna regret it. By the time you're 20, you're gonna be like, I'm okay. I mean, I already started working at 16 or 15 or 17, whatever. And you're gonna be fine. Parang, you'll be great. You'll do great. Yun. Yun lang.
I love that. Ano, being independent and finding yourself and going outside of your comfort zone to experience new things. So I think that's something. Kita man natin yung layers sa mga characters nila, yung mga hugot
nila. Yes, talaga direko. Iba-iba at... Yeah, very exciting.
Sobrang insightful. Can I have one more question
for
Jada? Jada, I saw your recent post last Valentine's.
Right.
Your dad gave you flowers, right? That's your tradition since you were 12 now. And he had a funny reply na, the bar is set high for suitors. Has anybody ever dared to make a romantic gesture or give you something?
Of course. I mean, there have been those moments, I will say, syempre. Ano, hindi na po tayo ba?
So what are your own like standards for a suitor if the bar is set that high?
I guess I wouldn't say that the bar is super high. I think it's just that the fact that I really do have my standards, honestly. And that goes for my parents as well. When my dad said in that message na they are welcome to try. Ito po masasabi ko po, I think I'm really just looking for someone who really respects me. And you know what I do, my craft, and someone who will be ultimately supportive and proud of me in whatever I do, and who will always be by my side. And you know, I think having that trust and respect is really important, and that's kind of what I look for in a partner.
Okay, wow. And in response to that, maraming fans ang nagsasabi na Aljan and Jada bagay na daw kayong magjowa. What's your reaction to this, Aljan?
Nakakatuwa yun. Pero, ayun. For now kasi, sobrang, halimbawa, marami kaming gestures sa isa't isa ni Jada na yung simple lang. Pero, alam mo yung totoo yung care. Yung hindi namin kailangan pilitin yung mga bagay para magmukha kaming sweet or parang need naming mag-pretend na parang kami. Something like that. Kasi sa ngayon, iniingatan namin yung relationship, yung trabaho, and kung paano namin nakikita itong project na ito, yung pagpapahalaga namin dito. Yung comment nila na bagay kami, natawa.
No, Aljan is a gentleman. He really takes care of Jada, and it goes both ways. They help each other out in the scenes, and kita mo sila na they really work hard, they practice their scripts together, and kita mo na may chemistry, they're both really good looking. So
thanks, Direk.
I would like to add rin, from Aljan and Jada, they really, really, really work hard together. As in, parang behind the scenes, they would literally be together. You know, they tend to hold hands as well before they do their scene and stuff. I really respect that eh, kasi there are a lot of moments na parang, you know, a lot of actors won't really, you know, talk to each other that much as well. So kudos to you guys, especially you, Jada. I'm honestly amazed on how you really projected yourself with Aljan with this show. So
thank you,
congrats,
that's
guys.
Really sweet. Thank you, Zach.
Ako, dagdag ko lang ha. Promise ha, kung casual viewer po ako, tapos nakita nyo po silang dalawa, iba yung kilig eh. Iba po talaga yung mararamdaman nyo kapag nakita nyo silang dalawa na parang, ano ba, acting lang to ah. Bakit parang totoo na? Parang ganun yung nakikita namin. So, kaya dapat abangan nyo talaga to.
Anybody else would like to add?
Grabe, ano, I was about to mention kanina kasi nung sinasabi ni Aljan na ang language of ano niya, love is physical, is intimacy, ganyan. Tapos parang tumutungo-tungo sila. Sabi ko, may something. Ayun niya. True enough, ayan. Nagsalita na sila. Kinikilig silang lahat. Even the co-stars.
Ayun, para, ano, hindi kami nagmamadali, pero sobrang happy namin ngayon sa kung anong ginagawa namin ni Jada. Tsaka, yung hands-hands kanina, may sinasabi kami na parang siya yung charger. So, pag naghahawak lang kami, ah, okay, full charge na. Okay, take na. Ganun, ganun.
So, makikita niyo ang dami na nangyari behind the scenes as well. And I think after Team Clash at 8 p.m., 9 p.m., may Clashmates. I think after, so pwede nila i-discuss na yung mga kilig moments, what goes on and behind the scenes. So, abangan nyo yan.
Ayan, aabangan po namin yan, Direk. Direk, matanong ko lang, no? Kasi this is in partnership with Black Sheep, a collab between Black Sheep and I1TFC. And kayo po, your background is into directing indie films. May adjustment po ba into doing a series na maraming episodes?
A big adjustment doing a series, no? No? Because usually sanay talaga ako sa movie. My last project with Star was Sen Island with Colleen and Cian. And when I transitioned to series, iba talaga. Kasi syempre may mga episodic yan. And you need to know the highs and the lows. And I'm so thankful that I have great writers with me. Polly and Simon and Kukai, you know, helping me out and really fleshing out all the scenes together. So Polly, how was the experience writing this series?
It's also my first series, and it was super fun because it's about youth. So I just wanted to, like, I just enjoyed it. I just remembered my own youth. I mean, it's not too long ago. I'm still 25, but like, I just kind of enjoy. I tried to just think about my own youth and then try to put all the fun, all the highs and the lows, and I placed it in the script. So here's Simon.
Ako naman siguro. In my case, aside from the useful aspect, ako na-excite talaga ako sa music aspect and element of the film. I guess it's not too often that we get to do something on music, I guess in Philippine television or movies or series. So having that as like your major element, you know, playing around with the instruments, with the band, how they clash, how they eventually harmonize and team up. Parang yun yung parang for me the excitement na wow, we're going this route now. We're now here and this is an opportunity to show king at the talents of these people that they're more than just actors. They're really performers and yun, very talented people. So yun lang.
Ayan, grabe.
Yeah, I'm so happy working with Black Sheep. Imagine working with two great young writers. Yes. And a young cast, and Black Sheep is open to doing a lot of things right now, and I'm so happy working with Black Sheep and I1.
Thank you, Direk. Curious na ako doon sa dalawang writers. Sabi niya, long time ago daw yung 20, dahil 25 na siya. Ano pa kaya tayo? Anyway, did you put a lot of your personal experiences into the content, into the plot?
Yeah.
I'm just curious lang. Yeah,
honestly.
What's your creative process? Eh?
I just kind of had fun. Like, I was just like, I tried to imagine myself as Zoe. So I tried to just be like, okay, when I was this age and I just wanted to like, you know, have fun, do crazy things. That's what I would make Zoe do. It's like, what would Zoe say? What would I say at that time, at that place? That's what I would make Zoe and the other characters as well do. And I based it on a lot of like own kilig stuff or own like fun moments. And that's what I tried to put here. Yeah.
Can I just say really quick? I just know when I'm reading the script, I just know when you've written a line for it. I just know. Tapos tinatanong kita, did you write this? And you'll say yes. So, I feel like her personality really came through.
Oh, well, ang cute. Okay, sige. Marami pang magtatanong. Next, let's ask a Gen Z. From Random Republica, we have Sandy Kagurangan. Ayan. Paabot ng mic.
Hi, good afternoon. So, first of all, I would like to congratulate everyone for Team Clash. Okay?
Thank you.
So, may question anyone can answer. Kung kayo, magkakaroon kayo ng chance na pumili ng character, will you still choose the character you have now or pipili kayo?
Nice question.
Me? Hi, I'm Andy. I'm playing the role of Mandy. And Mandy kasi is a fangirl. And coming out of PBB, I've seen a lot of people support me, how they really pour their hearts out in supporting me. And Mandy kasi, and I could relate Mandy to them. So, portraying the role of Mandy made me appreciate these supporters even more because kitang-kita kay Mandy kung paano niya binibigay yung puso niya para kay Zoe and kay Ice, para sa bandmates. And I would see that from my supporters every single day. And that's why I wouldn't replace my role, or I wouldn't choose a different role, because Mandy's, She's a very jolly person, and natutuwa ako kahit ako naaaliw ako sa ginagawa niya pagka umeeksena na kami. Yun.
Anyone?
Ako po, I don't think I would want to change my character kasi I think, like I said, I don't know if I said this before, but this is the most fun I've ever had, like, playing a character, especially under Direct Gino and our amazing writers right here. They just make it, the script, so... parang just, you can really feel the energy between everyone. And I like how I get to play around with it as well. And I can really relate to my character as well. That's why, you know, it's very fun. And syempre, if Andy is still wanting to play Mandy, she won't pick anyone else. Syempre, ako naman si Josh pa. I can't pick anyone else. No. If you're picking Mandy pa, I still have to be Josh. Diba? Kasi partners tayo.
Partners daw kayo.
Okay, to answer your question po, ano, I would say Sander has a lot of work to do. And I don't want to judge Sander as well. Kasi Sander is Sander. That's my character. I don't want to judge him. Pero if I were to choose, si Sander kasi is like, parang alter ego ko in a way. Kasi I tend to act alpha male once in a while, you know. Kasi I try to bring out my confidence to people. And it shows. And I would say Sander's like the toxic personality of mine. Parang ganun. And I would say. And yeah. Will I choose Sander's character? Yes. I mean, I would. Kasi si Sander really, he's actually passionate in a way, I would say. He's passionate with a lot of things. Just... he's just somewhat in a slump right now, I would say, and just got a lot of work to do. So, yun lang.
Ako po, honestly, I really wouldn't have it any other way. I feel like stars are aligned for us for a certain reason, and si Yanni, binigay niya siya sa akin ni Lord for a reason. I've learned so much from her, and from what I've learned from her, I want to see her grow. I want to see her grow, find herself, and siguro kumalas sa mga bagay-bagay na she's used to. That it's parang gusto ko lang siya alagaan. I wanna give her justice. I really wanna give this character justice. That hindi lang siya asong nakabuntot kay Sander. She's her own girl. She's finding herself, and gusto ko, I really want to be a part of that journey. So ayun, I'm very, very thankful for this role. So ayun po.
Yeah, dito lumang tayo sa side na to bago natin pasagutin yung sila Alzon. Ayan. Would you choose a different character na hindi nyo character? Ayan. Tama, that's a question, yes, Sandy, no?
Honestly, like, I wouldn't either, but I wouldn't be against it at the same time. Kasi, especially the girls, every single female character here is so different and so distinct. Kasi si Sab naman, she is of the LGBT community, diba? So that's another perspective to tackle. Si Zoe naman, she's a leader, she's very strong, and she has to be the, kind of the alpha female in our group, diba? Si Yanni naman, sobrang makalat and very dramatic, which is another a character that would be so interesting to portray. And then Mandy at the same time is so interesting because she's such an excitable character, very pure, and that's another side. So I feel like every single female character here has a different lens of what it means to be a female. And I think that's why it would be so important. And why not take the chance to be another character in this cast?
Kifana, may question ako. Yeah, in yes, relation to your like, LGBTQ role, did you have an apprehension portraying the role? Or did you consult something from the community? Or
ako po kasi marami akong friends from LGBTQ community. And nung una po, kinabahan ako, and it's a very challenging role. Pero I'm grateful na nabigay po sa akin yung role. Kasi I really want to support, of course, the LGBTQ community, and I know na maraming makaka-relate, especially the teens na nahihirapan mag-out, kahit teens pa lang sila, and if ako yung pipiliin, I still pick siguro Sab pa din po, and yeah.
Ito, question lang to, it's a random question. Marami na kasing BL series, no? I think maraming options. Do you think it's high time na dapat magkaroon naman ng GL series? Ayan.
Yes po. 100% yes. Yes po. Kasi for me po talaga dapat na kasi yung ibang tao hindi pa nila tanggapin everyone. Ay, yung ibang
mga tao. So gusto ko po na maging open ang lahat and maging, of course, proud. Proud sila. Yes.
Love wins. I think it's also important to tackle every single love story. You know? Lahat naman tayo may sariling love story and it's important to tackle everyone's journey.
Okay. How about you guys? Ayan. Pipili ba kayo ng character na hindi sa inyo eh?
Feeling ko po, magiging...
Ang feeling.
Hindi, siguro mag-stick na lang po ako sa role ko. Kasi na-enjoy ko na po siya. And bawat character po kasi swak na swak po talaga para sa amin. And kahit alam ko, hindi nga po ako matalino. Pero na-enjoy ko siya dahil meron akong natututunan dito sa role na to. Kaya, ayun lang, sobrang saya niya lang gampanan dahil marami ako natututunan sa character ko. Kaya hindi po ako mamimili ng ibang character. Mag-stick pa rin po ako. And sobrang saya niya po and sobrang kulit. So parang sakto lang din sa akin, di ba? Yeah. Ayun.
Ayan.
So yun, ako naman po, siguro po papapiliin ako. Si Lloyd pa rin po yung pipiliin ko. Kasi syempre, para po sa akin, nakaka-relate ako kay Lloyd, yung mga personality ni Lloyd. Parang ako rin, kay Inkoy, makulit, ganyan, palakaibigan, and pinapahalagahan din yung friendship. And yun, nag-a-advise. So parang hindi na ako nahihirapan to portray Lloyd kasi parang ganoon na rin ako in real life. So yun, si Lloyd. Si Lloyd pa rin po.
Thank you. How about you, Alzon, Jada, and Marcos?
Ako naman, I think once na minahal mo na yung character mo, hindi ka na titingin sa iba eh. Kumbaga, kaya nga importante na hindi mo i-judge yung character mo kasi kailangan mo isabuhay yun. So, I think, kaya lahat kami, kapag tinanong kung magpapalit, magsistick kami kasi nasa buhay na namin siya eh. Parang dala-dala na namin yung sarili-sarili naming character eh. So, ayun, yun yung reason kung bakit magsistick kami. Ako kasi nakaka-relate ako kay Ice. Ang dami ko nang nabigay na palaman sa buhay niya. Kumbaga, hindi naman kasama sa script. Nilagay ko yung mga playlist niya, kung anong mga favorite number niya, color niya, kung anong ginagawa niya bago matulog. So, parang na-attach na din ako sa kanya. So, kung lalo na ngayon nakapag-taping na kami ng ilang beses, I don't think magagawa ko yung character ni Sander or ni Josh kung minahal ko na talaga yung character ni Ice. Yeah.
Wow, talagang may accountability na dun sa character. Ikaw, Marcos?
Well, for me, bilang si Jude yung pinakamatanda dito sa cast, I feel like mas bagay talaga sa akin maging Jude. I don't think I have the teenage spunk anymore to keep up with the banda-banda energy. But no, of course, just getting to know the character of Jude, I kind of related a lot to him, especially since he's a songwriter too. But yeah, I wouldn't change. I can't wait to play Jude.
Ikaw, Jane.
Copy-paste po sa sinabi nilang lahat. Copy-paste. Hindi, pero I would really just echo the same sentiment that I really do feel really attached and invested kay Zoe. Kasi nga po, hindi po siya talaga nalalayo sa totoong personality ko po. And sobrang nagre-resonate po sa akin yung pati yung strengths niya, yung mga weaknesses niya. I feel like she's also really like a part of me at this point. And she also contains a part or parts of me, rather. So I really wouldn't have it any other way. But I would also say na ina-echo ko din yung sentiments ni Gail na all of these characters are so fleshed out well, which I have to give props to the creative team. Guys, you really did so well in making these characters so lovable. And masasabi ko po, pag napanood nyo po yung palabas na to, you all are gonna root for them. Kasi may mga kanya-kanya silang moments of charm and things to love about them. So yun.
Wow. Ang galing direct, parang they seem to know every fiber of their character. Paano eh? May technique ba yan na para yung character development nila?
Of course, binigyan namin mga assignments yan. At they really have a responsibility to create their own characters as actors, no? And also, ayun, a lot of teen movies na pinanood ko sa nadaming assignments, workshops, all that, and thank you to Miss Val and of course Inang for helping us also with creating these characters as well.
Ayan, Sandy, any more question?
Okay, na po. Thank you so much and congratulations.
Salamat. Thank you,
Sandy.
Thank you, Sandy Kagurangan of Random Republica. Our next set of questions from Chicanes Avenue, yeah, to represent the Boomer, char, the yan, Gen Z then. Sorry. Gen Z.
Grabe yung boomer. Ayan. Hey, mabuhay. Congratulations.
Hey. Hi.
Ayan. First question to Jada. Ganyan.
Hi,
so congratulations. We're very excited
with your acting
project. Ganyan. So, like earlier, parang sinasabi ni Aljon yung the collaboration he had with you. Ganyan. So, were you impressed with that gesture from Aljon? Does Aljon makes him a good suitor if possible?
Wow, matinding tanungan yan. Wow. Hindi, pero ito, masasabi ko na I would say that I am really impressed that sobrang na-appreciate ko yung kung paano siya committed dito sa project na to. And I was very upfront with that rin na dati pa po nung nag-uusap pa po kami before the project even started, I made it clear din kung ano yung mga goals and we were able to talk about that. We share so many things in common. So I would say na, you know, all of these moments during being on set with him and being with him throughout this whole process, ang masasabi ko, and I always do say this, like I'm always glad that, you know, that the person that I ended up being partnered with for this project was you. And, you know, like, I can't think of anybody better to be with throughout this kind of process and this kind of journey. And doon naman po sa pangalawang tanong niyo po, para po sa akin, habang may buhay, may pag-asa mo.
Nagpapakita ba ng parang pag-move si Aljon para magkaroon ng pag-asa?
Siguro po, what I can say po is we do have a genuine connection with each other, and those are, you know, good foundations of any kind of relationship. And honestly po, I think at this point, you know, I would say that wherever life takes us is I welcome that kung ano man itadhana po para sa aming dalawa.
Okay. Thank you, dear.
Ayan. Thank you po.
Aljon, coming from the previous love team, what can you put on the table with Jada na para mas ma-elevate yung experience at mas ma-enjoy ninyo yung pagiging partners ninyo in this series?
Siyempre, yung unang-unang ginawa at dapat gawin, don't compare. So, iba kasi si Jada kapag iba lahat ng makakatrabaho mo eh. And this time kay Jada, sobrang nagkakasundo kami sa tulad ng sinasabi namin, yung goal namin. Pero I think yung mas effective at mas na-appreciate namin yung genuine na kumbaga hindi na dapat kailangan itanong, nagkakaroon ng kusa, yung simple gestures na are you okay? Na-appreciate namin yun eh. Every time nakikita namin na parang nalulobat yung isa or napapagod, we're there for each other. Ayun. And sobrang talino ni Jada. Ang dami niyang naiisip na solutions or pwedeng suggestions every time may gagawin kami. So, na-enjoy ko yung conversations namin kasi napakatalino kausap. Ayun. And malaman. Kausap. And
how did you take care of Jada during the scene, yung nasa teaser? Kasi parang very suggest. Alam mo na yung nasa CR, suggestive, or ako lang bang may mali siya? Pero, like, direct, you know, may sinasuggest yun, ganyan. So, like, how was it for you, Jada, and Jada naman, what was the reaction of your parents na may ganoon eksena pala?
Siyempre, before pa namin ginawa yun, tinanong kami lahat. Tinanong nila lahat kami kung okay bang gawin namin yun. And syempre kami, game na game kami. And nung mga moment na tinitake namin yun, syempre, inaalalayan ko naman siya yung, kumbaga, hindi naman talaga totoong hinihila na masakit talaga. Syempre,
mapasapa
si Jada. And yun, ayoko siyang masaktan kasi lagi ko siyang chinecheck, okay ka lang ba? Or masakit ba yun? Sabihin mo lang sa akin kung nasasaktan kita or mahigpit yung hawak or baka mabagsak kita. And ayun, sinasabi naman niya, yeah, you're fine. Favorite line niya, yeah, you're fine. Okay.
Okay. May unan ba sa gitna? Charot lang hindi. Yeah, ano yung reaction ng parents, so dear?
Yung reaction po ng parents ko, honestly po, yung dad ko, may ganun, sabi niya. Hindi, pero honestly po, super open-minded po ng magulang ko po. And I really do appreciate them that they also were very supportive in me spreading my wings for this project. And I know that a lot of people may come to certain assumptions na baka parang, I guess, like, they're involved in sometimes parang, I don't know, an overbearing kind of way, but it's really not that way at all. Sobrang ano, supportive lang po talaga sila. And they are really open-minded in the sense that alam po nila yung mga galawan dito po sa industriyang to. And they really do have respect for the art of acting and what's in a script. And they're just, I guess, supportive in seeing me, you know, reach for my dreams and to be part of this amazing project po. So, ayun po.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Ayan ako, isusundot ko lang yung tanong, no, sa about your parents. Ang tanong ni Charmy Joy Pagulong of the Philippine Star. What specific advice? Kasi we all know that your parents are both showbiz icons. What specific advice did they give you in terms of acting and singing?
When it comes to my career, I think from the very beginning, like what I was always told, like unang-una po sa lahat, never po nila talaga akong pinilit pumasok dito sa industriyang to. And ito masasabi ko po na they always were very real with me in terms of laying out yung mga pros and cons sa pagpasok po dito sa industriyang to. You know, of course, there are ups and downs, and especially coming from this particular background, there's a different set of pressures that comes with it. Pero ito masasabi ko po, they would always tell me na make sure na you love what you do and hilig mo talaga tong art na to. And it's, of course, never, I think what my dad always tells me, and until this day, he always says, never lose your sense of yourself and yung mga core values mo as a person. Kasi nga, you're bound to meet so many people and so many experiences na kaya talaga meron talaga mga tao, they fall into the pitfalls of show business. But, you know, I really do have them just by my side to help me stay grounded, and I surround myself with the right people. And in terms of other advice of like with this project in particular, it's really just be humble, be teachable, and be willing to learn from every single one of these people. Everyone on set is equal in terms of what kind of knowledge you can earn and learn from them. So, ayun po.
To add to that, napaka-trooper ni Jada kasi yung mga scenes na nahuhulog sila sa banyo, may padding nga yun. Pero minsan nahuhulog talaga, natatamaan yung tuhod ni Jada. Minsan, so the next day, kita may makotik pasa. Sabi ko, oh no, baka magalit yung parents nito sa akin kasi may mga pasa. But she's such a trooper. No, it's okay, Derek. It's fine. It's part of the job. And you know that acting is a physical and emotional aspect that you need to use your body and your brain. So, okay lang yan for the project. So, thank you, Jada, for being such a trooper.
Thank you, Derek. And of course, thank you so much for your patience and for all the learning so far. And we're still continuing to tape, and I really do appreciate every single bit of information and yung tiyaga niyo po sa akin at sa amin pong lahat.
In fairness to Jada, for a very first acting project, looks promising, like based on the trailer. Talaga aabangan natin. Ayan. All right. Unfortunately, that's the time we have. Pasensya na dun sa hindi na umabot na tanong kay Kapamilya Online World, kay KPEX, and kay Manila Feed. Ayan. Baka may opportunity pa naman to ask them later. But at this point, may surprise daw. Balik sa'yo, Jello.
Yes, thank you so much, cast, and to our creatives and direct for sharing their insights for this very, very exciting project. And I would like to give a shout out to Smart and Palmolive for partnering with us. Thank you so much. And sa mga lahat ng nakatutok sa live stream po namin on ABS-CBN iWant TV. And Black Sheep, maraming salamat po. And quick trivia, the first poster for Teen Clash actually launched last January 2023, and it received some really, really good feedback, positive feedback sa mga fans and sa mga lahat nag-aabang sa series na to. So, without further ado, let us introduce the second poster!
Whoa! Woo! Wow!
Grabe!
Hey!
It's me.
Your poster.
Wow, grabe!
That's so exciting.
All right, so now that we've seen the second poster of Teen Clash, let's get the reaction naman of the creatives, Direk, and to the cast. Like, what is their initial reaction? Kasi first time lang nila nakakita ng second poster natin. And of course, to the press and sa mga nanonood sa live stream po natin na yun. So let's get the reaction right now. Let's start with whoever. Go ahead.
Ayun nga, first time namin makita yung second poster and nabigla ako actually. Pero napakaganda kasi yung texture niya, alam mong texture. Yung kulay niya, yung, you know, hindi, ang ganda. So, parang na-excite akong panoorin agad-agad na. Pero, and guys, anong sa tingin niyo yung poster natin? So,
ako, kitang-kita ko dyan, si Zoe, ready-ready na lumaban. Which I think it perfectly encapsulates each and every one of our characters' personalities. Props to the editing team who Woo! Made this amazing poster and the poster before that.
Yes!
I think it's like, it screams so much personality and gives an insight of what Teen Clash is all about. And gusto ko talaga yung color palette and talagang halatang pinag-isipan yan yung gusto ko dito sa project na to is with the creatives of in every aspect it's all so well thought of and the attention to detail is admirable and I really respect that.
At saka maganda po siya i-wallpaper sa phone.
Yes, so please share it on your online socials, no, the trailer and the poster, please share it.
Yeah, woohoo.
All right, so we'd like to invite everyone in I Want TFC na nakatutok sa live stream natin na yun to like and share the second poster and syempre kasama na rin diyan ang official trailer of Teen Clash. So go ahead guys, share it, spread the word. And Direk Gino, do you have any reactions sa second poster
ako,
natin?
Ako super excited. I'm excited for you guys to watch it again March 17, 8 p.m. Make it a habit to be your Friday night, no? It's every Friday, 8 p.m. Sama-sama nyo kami, maging barkada. And I hope you guys enjoy. So please tweet it. Yung mga fans, yung mga characters nyo, yung mga idols nyo, please support them. And sana po mabigay na justice yung Teen Clash. And excited po na rin kami mapanood nyo ang Teen Clash. March 17, 8 p.m. on I Want TV.
Woohoo! Alright, so thank you so much to the cast, to the Direk, to the creatives, and everyone in between. And syempre, with our respectable guests, the press, maraming salamat po. Everyone, we are inviting you to watch Teen Clash on March 17 na po on I Want TFC with ABS-CBN, mga kapamilya. So now, let's have a photo op with the cast, Direk, creatives, and everyone in between.